Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. I am back today with a collective haul for you. I realised I haven't done a haul on my channel for quite a while, and it's not that I haven't been shopping or anything like that, it's just that I haven't really like done a big shop. It's been like little bits over the last like few months, and it's just never kind of occurred to me to do a haul. So I've tried to get kind of a selection of the things that I've bought over, oh gosh, like some of this stuff I got like before Christmas, so it's probably not going to be available anymore, but I thought I would share it with you anyway because I always like to see this kind of thing. So I might not be able to tell you all the prices and stuff, but yeah, hopefully you might enjoy seeing what I've got. I apologise, I have no fairy lights in the back because I turned them on and they just kind of went on and then straight off again, so I think I might have broken them. Whoops. But yeah, I have actually ordered some more fairy lights because these ones have just been doing my head in because the little shades fall off and anyway, yeah, so I haven't got any fairy lights, but I'm sure that won't affect the viewing. I have actually got quite a lot of stuff to show you, so I'm just going to try and like plough through it. I'm not doing a try on haul this time, mainly because I just don't have the energy to do it. It takes a lot of energy to like try everything on and film it, and I've not been very well, and you can probably hear my voice is still a bit funny, so I just thought I would just go through some stuff and share it with you, and hopefully you might like it. I'll start with what I'm wearing. Actually, it is this top here with these sparkly flamingos on, and it's a long sleeved jumper. This was from Next. It was quite recent, so should be still in stock. I'll have a look. Obviously I'll link what I can down below. If it's not linked, it means I can't find it. But yeah, I saw this when I was shopping with my mum, and like both of us went up to it and like, yeah, immediately wanted it. So I bought it then and there, and then my mum has now bought one online, so we have to just make sure we don't wear it on the same day. But yeah, I really like it. It's quite a sort of thin knit, although it is still quite warm. I'm quite hot in it today, although it's not that cold anymore, but it's quite good for like spring, I think, where like the weather's just a bit all over the place. So yeah, that was this. I can't remember how much it was off the top of my head, so I will link it down below and let you know. I've also just got a couple of bits of makeup to show you that I bought. These must have been before Christmas. So I got my hands on the L'Oreal True Match Highlight. It's a liquid glow illuminator, prime, blend and highlight. And it's just a really lovely colour. I got it in, it says Icy Glow / Rose Glacé Glow. I don't know. It's in the pink tube anyway. And it's just, yeah, it looks really pretty on, so I like that. And then I also got another highlight from L'Oreal, as you can probably tell. I'm really into my highlighters at the moment. This is the L'Oreal True Match Highlight Powder Glow Illuminator Blush and Highlight. And I got this also in Icy Glow. I don't think they're the same, because this, like, the powder one has got three different colours, so it's got, like, a very light sort of peachy rose colour, a white, and then a blue. And actually I was a bit like funny about what on earth is a blue going to look like, but it looks really nice, and especially like in the winter it got like a really silvery highlight, which was nice. So yeah, I quite like these two, and I thought I would just pop them in because I was showing you everything else that I've bought recently. I'm going to do shoes next, because I have bought quite a lot of pairs of shoes. Oh, there's another one that I need to show you. I might find them at the end, or I'll just tell you about them. So the first pair of shoes that I bought were actually a bit of a like, what do you call it, like an impulse purchase. I was actually looking for like black shoes to wear for my work experience, but I just came across these on ASOS. They are like metallic pink, which is right up my street, sort of like loafer style, and they've got these little tassely bits here. They weren't very expensive at all. They're really comfortable. These actually come up a bit big. I got a 6, which is kind of usually what I am, 5.5 to 6. They do come up a little bit big though, so I might have to put some insoles in them, but I just thought like for the spring summer these were going to be beautiful, so I really like those. I then picked up a pair of shoes that I did kind of think I might be able to wear for my work experience, but They're a little more casual than I thought they were going to be, but they are gorgeous. So there's this pair of sort of black canvas shoes with white soles, and then they've got this floral embroidery on here, which I am loving at the moment. I've just like gotten a bit mad on the whole floral embroidery thing. But yeah, these were from New Look, and they have actually still got the price on because I haven't worn them. So these were $17.99. Again, they're really comfortable, and I think they're going to be really good for going into the summer, because although they're black, I think the floral sort of embroidery, you can wear them anytime really, can't you? So yeah, I got those. And then I did get some shoes from my work experience as well, because I kind of realised that I didn't have any smart shoes. So I picked up, don't fall off, my bed is literally covered in stuff to show you. So yeah, the first bits shoes that I picked up were actually boots, and it's these ones from New Look. The reason I like these so much is because they have a really good sole. I don't know if you can see that there. It's got like, I don't know how you describe it, but yeah, it's a good sole, because I have a habit of slipping over in shoes that don't have a sole, a proper sole, so I was really looking out for them. But yeah, they're just black. They've got like a zip detail on them on the side there, but actually it doesn't, I don't think it undoes. I couldn't get it to undo anyway. And then it's got like, let me just show you one so I can point things out. It's got like a kind of material bit around here. You've got the buckle there. And they're just really comfortable and really good for when I did my work experience. It was kind of a little bit snowy and icy and stuff, and these were just like perfect. I don't know how much they were. They weren't like ridiculously expensive or anything, possibly like under 20 quid, around that. But yeah, I was really pleased with those. And then the last pair of shoes that I picked up for my work experience, which I actually wore quite a lot, were these Patent Brogues. Is that what you call them? Brogues, I think. They don't have a particularly great sole. These were from ASOS, and I think they might have been for wide feet as well, which is why I really like them, because I have stupidly wide feet and can never fit into any sort of nice pretty shoes usually. I just like these because they're patent, which means they're easy to like clean, but they've also just got like stitching and stuff that just makes them look quite feminine. And yeah, they are really comfortable as well, and they're nice, like soft, they didn't rub or anything like that. Again, I'm not 100% sure how much these were. They weren't expensive at all, and if they're still available, I will link them down below. Okay, so next I've got a couple of pairs of trousers. I have got some more trousers to show you, but this is just what I've got in this pile over here. So I picked up these, I think in like January time, and they are a pair of leggings from Primark, so pretty boring. But inside they have like this velvety, like fluffy material, and they are just so warm. Like, it's not really the kind of thing I would probably wear out that much, and because they're not particularly like attractive or anything like that, but for like cold days or like when I couldn't really care less what I look like, they are just so cozy. And yeah, like seriously, I've had like fluffy leggings before, but these are just something else. They weren't expensive at all. Don't know if they're still going to have them in now that it's like March time, and I don't know if it's like a winter thing, but I can imagine they would probably bring these back next year. So it's something I would really recommend, because they are so cozy. Don't think they were more than £10, so would really recommend those. I then picked up a pair of skinny jeans. Well, no, they're not skinny jeans, are they really? They're jeggings, in a sort of dark blue denim, which are actually the same style of the skinny jeans that I'm wearing now, which are a lighter blue. And these are from Next, and they have got to be the most comfortable jeggings that I have ever found. They're so soft, and they've got like an elasticated waist, and they look nice. They like look like jeans, which is good for me because I like to wear jeans, but I never find them particularly comfortable. And so yeah, I just had to get, I actually thought I was getting the same color that I got that I'm wearing, but they turned out to be a bit darker, but I'm not that bothered really, because I'm happy with either of them. But basically I think I've got about three pairs now, because I just love them so much. I think I've actually still got the price on these ones, so they are They're just called Denim Legging from Next, and they are £22, so a bit, I suppose, more on the expensive side for a denim legging slash jegging, but I really think that they are worth it because I love them, and yeah, I am slowly building up a collection of them in different colours because I love them that much. Something that I got last year sometime, I think it must have been towards the end of the year because yeah, that's when I think I bought it, but I've been wanting to share it with you guys for ages and I keep forgetting, and it is this from Primark again, Toy Story, I think it's like a nightshirt, I suppose, and I saw, I can't remember who it was, someone, another YouTuber shared it in their Primark haul, and as soon as I saw it, I told my mum, like, we need to get to Primark. And I really, like, I couldn't find it anywhere when we went, and then all of a sudden, like, saw it on, like, a little stand. And they're just so cute. It was £5. It's not going to be in store anymore, but Primark always have cute, like, pyjamas and stuff. And I haven't worn it yet because it's not actually been warm enough. But yeah, I just love it. It's got, like, Rex up here with the toys are back in town, and then Slinky, like, coming out, and then the cloud thing as well. I just think it's going to be lovely to wear in the summer, and I love it. It's so cute. And £5, like, you can't go wrong for £5. Okay, I've now got a few other things to show you, a few of which I got before Christmas, and a few of which I got sort of more recently. Some of them I haven't actually worn yet, so I can tell you how much they were, but I got this like yellowy orange top from Primark. I just love this, like, mustard colour, especially for, like, autumn, which I had planned to wear it in, but didn't get around to it for some reason, so I'm going to hang on to it, and I think it'll be fine for, like, spring, summer, because it's quite thin. It's got, like, the three-quarter length sleeves, and then the neck is sort of a higher neck, and on the back it's just got this little, like, opening and buttoned up at the top. But yeah, I just really liked it, and it's really pretty and loose and whatever. That was £8, so, and they always do stuff like this, like, they're not going to have this one in now because this was, like, quite old, but they always have, like, nice little things like this, so it's always worth keeping an eye out for stuff like them because I just think they're really pretty. And then I got another shirt from, yeah, Primark as well, and it is this white shirt with all these little, like, illustrations on it. It's just really cute. It's just a button-up shirt. It's quite soft and it's very floaty, and it's just got, like, ladybirds, pencils, horseshoe, butterfly, a pineapple, like, just loads of random stuff, and I love the Primark shirts. I just think they're really comfortable, easy to wear. This is quite see-through, so I can't remember if I needed to wear something underneath it, but yeah, it's just got the long sleeves with the buttons, and yeah, just a nice casual shirt really, and this one was £7. I then picked up something else when I was in Next, and I saw it on the hangers, like on the rails, and we went past it and I just kind of glanced at it and I was like, oh, I quite like that, but then I was like, no, like, I don't think I'll wear it, or like, I don't really have an occasion to wear it for, and then I don't know, we got like halfway around the shop and I just thought, oh, I really like that top. So we went back and I thought, I'm just going to try it on. So I tried it on and loved it. I don't know how well this is going to show up on camera. But basically it's got like a pink cami underneath. And then over the top it's got this really, like, I don't know, see-through-y sort of, I don't even know how to describe this material. It's so pretty. It is see-through, and it's just got loads of little flecks of like silver and gold in it. And it's just so pretty, like, it's, oh, I love it. It just glimmers because it's got so much like gold and silver. I just thought it would be lovely for, like, I don't know, parties or special occasions, but like, I think you could get away with wearing this, you know, in the day or like to work or something. I just love it. It's got long sleeves that are like elasticated at the bottoms, and the I think the camisole and the cami and the bit over the top actually come apart, so you could wear them separately for like other things. But yeah, I just think it's so pretty. And this was £24 and I got it in a size 10. I can vary between like a 10 and a 12. And I was a bit worried that the 10 wouldn't fit, but actually it comes up quite big. So yeah, if you're looking for something like this, I would recommend sizing, well, going on the smaller side. Don't know if this is going to still be in. I didn't get it that long ago, so it may well still be available. So I then picked up a couple more pairs of trousers. This is when I was looking for stuff to wear for work experience, because I just didn't have anything smart, because I've never really needed it and I'm not a particularly like smart person. So yeah, I went looking for sort of smarter trousers. The first pair that I picked up were from Primark. I don't know, it's gonna be a bit difficult to show it on the camera. So they're this like khaki green colour. They're not like smart, but they do look quite nice on. So they are like full length, they've got like a little turn up at the bottom. I don't think the colour is showing up particularly well. They are like a khaki green, although they seem to look black. And then they've got this like tie here with little silvery bits on the end. Zipped pockets, although I don't actually think that they're real pockets. No, they're not real pockets, they're just fake. And then a nice elasticated waist, which I love, because you know, you've got to go for comfort. So yeah, they're really comfortable. I didn't actually wear them in the end because they're quite thin and it was too cold. But these were £13, so you know, they're going to be great for like spring and summer, because they're so like thin. They're not like thin, but they are not particularly sort of warm trousers. So yeah, I really like those. And then I went to back at Next. I've always gone to Next for like smart trousers when I used to work and stuff like that. So I found a couple, well, I tried quite a few pairs on actually, but I'd narrowed it down to two. So I got these like navy, well, the colour's in debate because my mum reckons that they're more of a black, but I think they're navy. So yeah, these navy pinstripe trousers, they're a bootleg flare type fit. And yeah, they're just pretty boring, but they're comfortable. I think they were 20 something pounds, I can't remember off the top of my head. But Next are really good for like workwear and stuff. So I got those ones, and then I picked up a black pair as well. I don't know, they're a bit of an odd material, but I found them really comfortable. They kind of feel a little bit stretchy, but they've just got two little, I think these are actually poppers. Yeah, they've got two little poppers there, little like pockets there again, and same sort of shape, the boot cut flare. And I think they were 20 something pounds again, and just, I think it's a good thing to have in your wardrobe if you're going to need something smart to wear, and you don't want to wear a dress or something. So yes, I've got those. And then this isn't actually something that I've bought. You might have seen it in a blog post if you follow my blog. If you don't, the link is down below, so go and have a follow. But I was really kindly sent an outfit by Simply Be, who, like, up until like last year, I had never really thought to look at their clothes, but actually they go down to like a size 12, sometimes like lower, and they have some really lovely stuff. So they contacted me and asked me if I would like to do a post about being like a wedding guest, and I jumped at the chance because I am going to a couple of weddings this year and I love like trying to choose an outfit and stuff. So I picked my outfit myself, they kindly sent it to me. So I went for this dress, which is going to be really difficult to show, but I will try and insert a picture as well from my blog. But basically it's got this black sort of three-quarter length top, an elasticated bit around here, and then this gorgeous like floral skirt underneath, and it's got like a sort of netted petticoat as well, so it's a bit like puffy. And it just comes down to like, I think it's just to my knees actually. And I just love it. It's so comfortable. It looks really nice. I was a bit like not sure about getting black for a wedding, but I think like with the like bright floral skirt, it's absolutely fine. And I would happily wear this to a wedding or to a party or anything like that. So yeah, I really, really like that, and I'm very grateful to Simply Be for sending me that, because yeah, I will be wearing it a lot. They also sent me, where is it? So basically I had to kind of pick my own outfit. So they also sent me a bag that I picked, which I just think is beautiful. It's this like rose, like blush pink colour bag, and it's got a grey, a gold, I don't know what I'm thinking about today, a gold bow, which I just thought looked a little bit Ted Baker-y. And I think it goes really well with that dress as well. And you just open it, it's got a little sort of button thing, and it's actually quite spacious inside, so you can either hold it like a clutch, or it has got a long handle as well. I probably prefer holding it as a clutch, just because I think it looks more, I don't know, more smarter. That's not a word at all. It looks smarter, but it is useful to have the longer handle there for if you were out and you needed your hands for things and what have you. But yeah, I love the colour, and this is something I will happily use, not just for weddings, but for any occasion. If they've still got it, I will link it down below. I cannot remember the price, but it wasn't much at all. And again, the dress was really reasonable value. So yes, thank you very much to Simply Be for sending those, because I am very grateful and I really like those. Right, the last few things are things I've got fairly recently, so hopefully they will still be around. The only one that I didn't get recently was this jumper from Primark. It's like a lovely mustard yellow colour. I actually got this, it might have been just after Christmas actually, but I really love the colour. It's a really lovely like thick knitted jumper. I like the pattern on the front, and I just think it brings a bit of like bright and cheerfulness to like when it's wintry and horrible. I don't know if they're still going to have it in, and I can't remember how much it was, but you know, it's Primark, it's not going to be that expensive, and they always have like jumpers like this around like autumn winter time. So yeah, I love these kind of jumpers. Just thought I would show you that. And then the rest of the stuff that I'm going to show you is stuff that I have got sort of in the last month. So you may have seen this jumper in one of my other videos. I think it was my eating disorder video. And it is this sort of creamy jumper here with the gorgeous like rose embroidery and the big funnel. I don't know what you call that. What do you call that neck? It's not like a roll, it's not a roll neck because it's bigger. Anyway, it's so soft. This was from New Look. I got it maybe last month, and it is just the softest jumper I think I've ever found, and it got so many compliments. Like every time I've worn it, people have like asked where it's from and said they really liked it. So yeah, I love it. And as I said earlier, like the embroidery trend is just, yeah, I would happily have everything embroidery in my wardrobe right now, because I just think it looks so pretty and feminine. And with this jumper, it just looks like I've made a bit more of an effort without having to actually make an effort. You know, I put it on and it looks like smart. I don't know, anything that can do that, I'm more than happy to wear. I then did a wee bit more shopping on the New Look website. So I picked up this t-shirt, which is typical me really. It just says cats are forever. I saw a friend of mine actually, she posted about, she had one on Facebook, and I saw it and I just thought, oh, that's very me. Like, as you know, I have cats and my blog is named after my cat. So I saw this and I just thought, yeah, that would be great for spring and summer. It's a really nice fabric actually. I don't know what it is, but it feels really like soft. And this was $7.99, so bargain for a nice little white t-shirt there. I then found something that I've never really tried before, and I've kept wanting to try it but just not really ever got round to it. So it's this frilly sort of, I would say pink, but it's come out more of a sort of salmon colour I think. But it's got these cold shoulders, so you get the sort of bit up there, and then you've got the shoulder bit here, and then the arm that goes down here to sort of quite a big sleeve. And I just thought it looked really pretty for sort of the warmer months, if they ever decide to show their face. But yeah, I really love it. It's got this frilly bit here, and then it just goes down quite straight like that. Zips up at the back, and I really like it. And it was, that was £19.99, so I think that's going to be lovely for the summer. Right, I have two more things to show you. So next up is something I actually saw Victoria from In The Fro wearing on one of her videos. It's kind of similar to the jumper that I just showed you, but it's not the same. Like, this is what I keep telling myself to convince myself to buy it. So it's this grey jumper. It is thinner than the other one that I just showed you. Again, it is from New Look, but it's got these like embroidered pink and white roses with little butterflies, and it's got sort of a fairly high neck, which that's the only thing I'm not a massive fan of. I don't like high necks, but I thought this one would be okay as it's not like super high, so it's just about manageable for me. It is a bit cropped, but it's not a problem. Like, it still covers my tummy, which is the main thing. And yeah, it's just really nice. As I said, it's not as thick, so it's quite good for as it's starting to get a bit warmer. You don't want such a thick jumper. I think I've still got the price in this one as well. So this was £27.99, so a little bit more on the expensive side, but it's a really nice quality jumper, and I love the embroidery with the butterflies. I just think it's so pretty. And then the last thing that I was going to show you has a bit of a story behind it. So basically, a couple of years ago, Topshop did a bright yellow rain mac, and I saw it originally and I thought, oh, that's really cool. And then I kept thinking about it and thinking like, oh, I quite liked it. Shall I get it? Shall I not? And I sort of ummed and ahed about it for ages. And in the end, I was like, yeah, I'm going to get it. I'm going to get it. Went on the website and it sold out. Didn't come back in at all. I've kept my eye on the website literally for the last 2 years, and it's never come back in, or I've never seen it come back in anyway. So I kind of just like admitted to myself that I'd missed out and I wasn't going to get it. And then this year they've brought out a load of pastel ones. They have like a pink one, which I was very tempted by, but I was like, no, I'm going to stick to my guns. So they've got a white one, they've got a mint one, I think they've got a lavender one, like loads of gorgeous ones. But they had a pastel yellow one. So I just thought, I'm going to buy it. I'm not going to miss out again. So I bought it. It's just so pretty. It's got like this hood with the stripes inside. It's got stripes down the inside of there, and then on the arms, the arms will turn up, and you've got the stripes here as well. You can turn the arms down, so it's like a full length. But I just think it's so cute. Like, I don't know, it just like reminds me of like a typical rain mac, of like what you should wear when it's raining. I don't know, it's really comfortable actually. It's got massive pockets, which is really good. And it's like, it's always raining, so it's going to get a lot of use. But I really love it. That was from Topshop, I can't remember if I said. It was £49, so not the cheapest, but it is a coat, so you kind of expect to pay a bit more. But I love it. I'm really happy with it, and I love the pastel yellow. It's like, the bright yellow was lovely as well, but I just think the pastel yellow is really nice for sort of spring. So yeah, I am really happy with that, and really happy that I finally managed to get one. And that, I think, is everything. Like, oh my gosh, I'm a bit tired now. So yeah, that is kind of the bits and bobs that I have bought for the last like 4 or 5 months. I really hope you've enjoyed seeing some of the shopping that I've been doing. Sorry I haven't kind of done it more regularly, but it just didn't work out with everything else. So I hope you've kind of enjoyed this big collective haul. Yeah, if you have enjoyed it and, you know, would like to see more, I would really appreciate if you subscribe to my channel. There's also a little bell you can press so that you get notifications when I upload. If you could give me a like and a comment, I would really appreciate that as well. And go and check out some of my other videos, or tell your friends about them. There's also my blog down below that you can have a read of too. And yeah, I just hope you're all well. It has been nice to chat to you again, and I'm sure I will see you in another video very soon. Bye!